was supposed to read in a consumer conference report. I said, Doctor, I got this consumer conference report from my utility, and they said I'm supposed to ask you. And the doctor looked at me like I was crazy, and he says, don't drink the water. You know, so that's what's very frustrating. The purpose for this meeting for us tonight is to talk about treatability. When we respond in these situations, we respond only bringing to the table our experience in other areas. We've heard about PFOA and PFOS. Those were part of the EPA's unregulated contaminant monitoring rule 10 years ago. Okay, those are the precursor chemicals to the Gen X. They're still in the drinking water supply. Okay, there are, thanks to local scientists who've done a tremendous job in investigating this, not only have they identified the PFOA and PFOS, but they've identified, you know, scores of other related compounds. They've also identified other contaminants in the Cape Fear River. You've heard this one, 1,4-dioxane. What I bring to the table today is I've been treating 1,4-dioxane for 22 years in a Superfund site in California successfully. It does not come out on granular activated carbon of any of the 600 types that are readily available in the water treatment market today.